Missed Wednesday's show? Here's the recap, presented by Honda.
Do we know who the individual that did not vote for Jeter as a Hall of Famer? Do we know who that person is?
Haven't heard yet, but I'm sure they are searching for him all over the place, him or her. I just hope that they just felt like he wasn't qualified to be a Hall of Famer. Okay? That's your opinion. That's what you want to say. But I sure hope it's not a publicity stunt. It will be fleshed out in due time, and that will be a conversation to be had. But we all have a love for Derek, right? But we'll see. I mean, we're going to hear from this individual, and I just wonder what they have to say.
What do you think of this matchup? I love it.
The thing I love it is the yin and yang. You know, we got the spread out offense of the Kansas City Chiefs, the great defense of San Francisco. It's old versus new, good versus bad, cats versus dogs. I mean, it's the whole thing.
What advice would you give Kyle?
Well, the good thing for Kyle is, like you said, he sat at dinner every night talking football with his dad. You know, obviously, he didn't have that experience. I remember Dan Reeves reached out to me, which I thought was great. He sat for a good hour and a half telling me about how to orchestrate the week and what you needed to. And then when he got done, he says, well, you know what? I haven't won one of these things, so just do the opposite of everything I just told you.
Rex Lynn is here on the Rich Eisen Show, everybody. When we came with the idea of CSI Miami, we had to knock on your door.
When you walked out of your trailer,
yes,
in full, authentic Horatio gear, from the red hairpiece,
it's amazing.
The sunglasses, to his shirt and that dark blue jacket, honest to God, I smiled outside and inside so much. I got into it as much as you did. All of a sudden, I was thinking, well, wait a minute, he can't walk before me because the grunt detective has to go first, and then Horatio has to make his cool stud, you know, appearance. So it turned out great for me, too. I was having a blast.
Yeah.
Sometimes you have to revisit a space or a time, and I hadn't been able to do that until you asked me back, and I got to revisit CSI Miami, so I want to thank you for that.
Yeah, you got it.
Chris. All right, HR, who's most deserving of Hall of Fame enshrinement? Pete Rose, Barry Bonds, and Roger Clemens?
I have a hard time with Pete Rose not being in the Hall of Fame. I understand. I'll probably get crushed by a lot of people, but 4,256 hits, and I know the gambling thing came as a manager. As far as I know, he could have been gambling as a player, too, but I just think that as time comes, I'm watching the softening stance of Bonds and Clemens with steroids, and I think people are glossing over Pete Rose, and I think Pete's got to be in the Hall of Fame.
Who is the one person who filled out their Hall of Fame ballot and said Derek Jeter is not a Hall of Famer? If you're not going to treat this seriously, then get out of the way.
You're letting this one little ant ruin your entire picnic.
A Boston sports fan, you said to me, why are you so focused on the negative for sports? Why can't you just look at all the yachts that you're water skiing behind?
Exactly.
We're talking about the Hall of Fame.
For more Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV or download the Rich Eisen Show app.